Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Ms. Marvel Season 1, Episode 3, titled Destined. Ahead of Amir's wedding, Kamala may face grave consequences due to a crucial decision she makes. Now, apparently, and this has been pointed out by several other reactors, and is what I initially thought at the end of episode 2, that the woman, Cameron's mum, is the same actress who was playing her great-grandmother in those Bangle visions, or at least who we assume is her great-grandmother. And her name in the credits is Najma. Was it Najma or just Naja? Yeah, Najma. Now, apparently, not an actual comics character. So has no comic-based ties with Kamran or anything. And so, got no idea what her deal is. But we're probably going to find out very quickly whether she is an ally or an enemy. And for we know she could be the big bad of this series. But, well, if she's the big bad of the series, then that would make sense given, yeah, but, anyway, gonna talk about this episode. I'm going to assume that this is the episode where we get Kamala using her powers at, like, the party. So it's at Amir's wedding where she's in the dress and using her giant fist with the party tables all behind her. I'm not very good at describing this scene. I don't know why my words aren't working today, but that means it's a perfect time to do a reaction. Let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Subtitles will be down there. Aisha, yeah. So, people think that Najma is Aisha. She really does look like Marty McFly. Still reckon he's going to, team up against D.Va at the end of this series? Did they slow this down? Or is it just, it seems faster with the normal Marvel fanfare? We're going to see partition. I probably should have checked that that's actually the time it is before. It did say British occupied India, so. So she's what, at least a century old? Also, it's on a blue arm. That's what you should be more concerned. So these are the Nega bands. What are you? Well, that was 10 rings. Take us back home. So, interesting. That revealed a lot, but also, really? clandestines. These names sound familiar. That's probably not a good thing. That was probably cathartic for them. Was that the kid that stole shoes? Too late for that. They do have a very wholesome family. It's always funny when characters accidentally talk bad about themselves. It is what you do. Yeah, so she basically just told him that. He gave her the domino mask. That was not nice. You just need the other one and click them together. I mean, but she wants to be, or wants to be like her. You don't have a bike. Very sweet talk. First time we actually see like text. We've been here for a century. Do you really think time's an issue? Is that the Hulk one? I think I saw the... Yep. Bruno, go with it. Really? They've still got Bon Jovi playing? Okay. I mean, that's a fair comment, but did he really need to punch that guy? Oh shit. Is no one going to comment on how one of them seems to have, inhuman strength? Because he cracked the floor. Nakia, don't do something stupid. You don't have superhero powers. What's that? Mace? She's got a spear. He's got a belt whip. I didn't see what that was. Was it still the frying pan or? Ow. Oh. Double fist. They're taking Cameron as well. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, that was a fun episode. It didn't have the same editing that the first two did. In fact, it went for a more traditional editing when it came to the texting and all that. But I don't really know how I feel about that, because on the one hand, it was fun seeing all the I think I'm honestly, I think I wanted this without any major villain or anything. Just seeing Kamala and her family while she understands her powers. I think that was what I was wanting after the first two episodes, but don't get me wrong, the fighting was fun in that, and seeing their weapons and that was interesting, but I don't know. But once the action took a back seat from the characters' stuff in my enjoyment, which is very rare. So, I wonder what the EOTC is going to do with the Jin. What they're going to do with Kamran. What did she say they were called? Let's see, where was the one they were sitting on the couch? First off, huh. Interesting. So, clandestine is the name of a fictional family of powered individuals. Clandestine is the superpowered progeny of Atom of Destine and Alaith, a djinn. Huh. So, they didn't just pull that out of their ass. That's actually a completely disconnected thing from Miss Marvel. Interesting. Yeah, because looking at the art style on the wiki page, this is an old creation. Affiliations. Allies, X-Men, enemies, X-Men. Ready. Huh. So, these seem like... Well, they seem to be a neutral faction. Where they're both friendly and enemies with... Heroes. I'm gonna have to look into this. I've never heard of these. Yeah, I've never heard of this group. When were they in publication? I've had comics as late as 2008 at the... Huh. Interesting. So, they've completely changed it up from being inhuman to a clandestine. Huh, that is... That is very interesting. So, it seems like this clandestine group is like the X-Men or like the Inhumans, where in which each seems to have a different power. But they all have longevity. Heck, half of these don't even have their powers listed on. Energy projection for one of them. That one doesn't have it. Animalistic adaptation for one of them. Interdimensional and time travel. Size alteration. Elemental summoning. That's all from one of them. There was one that was clairvoyance. So these are another similar group to where in which each member has a different power. Huh. Interesting. Gonna have to look through the current members, because those were all former members, to see if any of them match what we were shown in this, because, like I pointed out, they're the progeny of Adam of Destiny, and one of them's name was Adam, but with two A's. So, is there a direct link to that, or... Huh. Because he was the one who cracked the floor, the one with the mace. And I commented that he seemed to have some sort of strength that the others didn't, because they'd also hit things that didn't leave as much of an impact. And there was the one who caught his arm on fire and didn't seem fazed by it. Then again, it was just his jacket and he ripped the sleeve off, but... My computer's telling me I've been recording for too long. Or at least the fan is, so I'm going to end this here, but Oh, I've got a lot to look into with... New Rockstars is probably going to release a video in the upcoming days saying Clandestines Explained, so I don't really have to do this. But... So that completely changes the trajectory of this. Suddenly, I'm not as opposed to having them in the show if it helps me learn about another super-powered group like those. Because in this one episode, we had the 10 rings on the ground, we had these people, and they pulled the bracelet off a severed blue arm. Meaning it was a Kree arm. So, that could very well mean that the two come together to form, like, the Negabands. I always hesitate to say that, but... What's his called? Paraphernalia. It could be the Quantum Bands as well, but... He's not exactly Kree, is he? Yeah, no. Yeah, so he's human, he's not Kree, so it wouldn't have been him. Interesting. Huh. Well, I'm gonna end this here. I'll catch you in the next one.